Now comes the agonizing part in deciding which one I like the best, the original or this remake. Let's find out. The Wolfman. So the Wolfman, since the moment I found out about this movie's production, it had problems up the ass. For one thing, it was supposed to come out in February of 2009, okay? And then it got pushed back to, I believe, March of that same year. I was working at FedEx at the time, so I always looked at updates about this movie. Then I found out it got pushed back a whole year to February of 2010. I'm like, oh, this cannot be good. And of course, I bought the Blu-ray on Black Friday 4 years ago. And I sold it right afterwards. So I decided to rewatch this movie to see if anything gotten better. Not really. The Wolfman is a slow-paced movie. I mean, slow than shit, okay? So let's talk about the plot. So the plot is, of course, Benicio Del Toro's character is coming back, of course, to England because he found out his brother has been mauled by a savage beast, and also to reconcile with his dad, Anthony Hopkins, of course. And along the way, he is bitten by a werewolf, so we think. It was actually a wolfman in disguise. But, yeah. And so, he starts to turn into a wolfman of himself and decides to start to wreak havoc everywhere he goes when he actually turns into a wolfman. Granted, that's not bad because the gory effects are awesome, okay? I love it when the first wolfman takes his hands and stick it up a man's mouth and his claws are coming out the guy's mouth. That was cool. I love all the gory shit. I didn't have a problem with that. I like the fact that he was running on two legs and then when he has to run on all fours, they actually have him run on all fours. Granted, it's CGI and not very good CGI, but yeah. The transformations are nice, even though you can obviously tell it's CGI. But at this point, you couldn't really do it any other way to make it look good. Well, maybe you can, but it's not a horrible movie. It's just not a very interesting one. Benicio Del Toro, he's a hit and miss actor for me. I like him as the collector because he doesn't really say much, so that's a good thing. When he actually starts speaking, yeah. Granted, this movie is directed by Joe Johnston, who 1 year later will go on to direct Captain America: The First Avenger. Granted, he did have Kevin Feige and Marvel behind him, so that was a better movie, not by his part, but because it's Marvel's part, but yeah. Not a very good directing choice for this time around for Joe Johnston. Emily Blunt, oh yeah, she's always awesome to look at. I mean, she's mainly the reason why I kept going through this movie. Well, besides I have to review it, but yeah. And Anthony Hopkins, don't have to say anything about Anthony Hopkins at this point. Y'all know Anthony Hopkins is the shit. He's not going to let you down, even though he doesn't have a very good script to work with. But he's not going to let you down. So that's another plus. And then you got Hugo Weaving. To Hugo Weaving's credit, he doesn't really... He talks. Not a lot. But he's not terrible. He's there to do what he has to do. And that's about it. I do love the throwdown between the two Wolfmans. Toward the end of the movie, of course. That was cool. And yeah, if you can struggle with the fact that you see the Wolfman maybe 4 times throughout the movie, because the Wolfman supposedly turns every once a month, so every 15 minute intervals will do get the Wolfman transformation. It's just a very slow 15 minutes, unfortunately. I still kind of enjoyed the movie, but it's just not that interesting. So I'm going to give the Wolfman a C+. I gotta give the edge to the original, because the original was a better movie. So let me know what you guys think about the Wolfman down below. Did you like it? Did you hate it? And I'll catch you guys later.